Today, we will be talking about nanotechnology, small ideas with big impacts. To start with, this is a rather tricky subject, so I will need the help of my assistant, Professor C. Arbon. But where is he? Ah, here he is. Hello, Professor. So what is nanotechnology? Let's take a look at the dictionary.
Nanotechnology, the branch of technology that deals with dimensions and tolerances of less than 100 nanometers, especially the manipulation of individual atoms and molecules.
That seems rather complicated. Let's start from the beginning. You have probably already heard a bit about nanotechnology and some of the amazing things that it will do for us. But what exactly is nanotechnology? Well, nanotechnology is the design and engineering of things at the nanoscale. What is a nanoscale, I hear you ask? The prefix nano comes from the Greek word nanos, which means dwarf. Whereas a millimeter is 1/1000th of a meter, 1 nanometer is 1/1000000th of a meter. A single hair from your head is 60,000 nanometers wide. 1 nanometer is only about 6 atoms in width. So, you want to see some nanotechnology, huh? Well, all we need is a really strong magnifying glass, right? Wrong. Sorry to disappoint you, but unfortunately, even light itself is far too big to see nanotechnology in action. You see, the smallest wave of light is about 400 nanometers across. To see nanotechnology, we need to use something different. In the 1980s, several machines were developed to enable us to see this tiny world. One of these was the Atomic Force Microscope, or AFM as it is known. This works similar to a record player. A tiny needle moves across the surface, recording the patterns it feels. This tool and many other advances in technology are giving us complete control of the way we make and design things at smaller and smaller levels. Nanotechnology is all about building things up at the atomic level up, a bit like a tiny version of Minecraft or Lego. The idea for the future is that we will have tiny machines in nanofactories assembling things for us. In the near future, we may even have nano 3D printers in our own homes. Imagine the ultimate recycling tool. Need a new phone? Get your nano printer to make you one from the atoms of your old phones. These tiny machines could do other stuff for us too. Imagine if your stuff could repair itself when it breaks. Putting nano-sized robots or nanobots inside our products could make this possible. At the nanoscale, the properties of materials behave differently. The graphite in your pencil normally seems soft and weak when you write on paper, but when you look at the nanoscale, it turns out to be made of stacked, super strong, slippery sheets of carbon called graphene, 100 times stronger than steel. This stuff looks like chicken wire fencing, but if you had a cloth made of this material, it would be bulletproof, but also lightweight. Further research is happening today into ways of making larger amounts of this magical material. Nanotechnology has potential uses in many other fields as well. Doctors want to use hollow nano-sized balls to deliver medicine within the body. These nano balls are being designed to only release medicine at the right location, sort of like how your key can only open your house in your street. Engineers are working on thin nano coatings to be applied to glass or mixed into paint so your shower glass doesn't fog up and so that ice doesn't stick to your car on cold mornings. Some of these things are still in development. But scientists, engineers, chemists, mathematicians, and regular geniuses like Professor C. Arbon are hard at work making this tiny future a big reality.